Oysters are ubiquitous in Rhode Island, but when locals want the freshest, they come here to Matunic Oyster Bar, just outside Providence, for the best pond-to-plate bites.
What started as a small oyster farm in 2002 has grown into a year-round restaurant showcasing the bounty of coastal New England. With farm-fresh veggies, monster lobster rolls, and succulent homegrown shellfish.
Whoa, man.
These freshly shucked shells are incredible, but there's a truly indulgent seafood treat that blows all the other oysters out of the water. Matunic's Oyster Trio. Three pairs of buttery broiled oysters served with garlic and herbs, chipotle bourbon, and Rockefeller sauce.
It's really good. That is sinful.
I don't think I've ever had anything like this before in my life.
Hey, Jeff, how are you, man?
Good, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, brother. Not a bad place.
Not a bad place to work every day.
You know, I kind of like oysters. So, Jeff, we're going to make the trio of oysters.
Oyster trio.
So where do we start?
We're going to shuck some oysters. You want to give it a shot?
I want to give it a shuck.
Fun fact, I used to work at a raw bar in Jersey, so I know my way around an oyster shell.
And this side, you want, it's a little bit deeper. It holds all the actual juices that are in it, that briny flavor that we love so much. So I should just keep shucking, huh, Chef?
Yeah, shuck away.
Six fresh oysters shucked, we get started on the trio of toppings.
We're going to make our oysters Rockefeller first.
Yes.
Right?
A recipe dating back to 1899 New Orleans, Rockefeller sauce starts with butter sauteed shallots flavored with Pernod liqueur.
And these flavored liqueurs like Pernod are added to seafood to add a little bit of a licorice flavor. It won't get too sweet. Oh yeah, buddy. Sip on that.
We add heavy cream, tarragon, and Parmesan cheese, creating a sauce as rich as Rockefeller himself. Then we can assemble our trio.
The first layer that we do is a little bit of spinach, and then the Pernod cream sauce that we just made.
We finish the Rockefellers with Jeff's decadent version of breadcrumbs.
So these are buttery crackers and bacon fat.
Yeah.
And keep moving.
This is our bourbon butter. It's kind of sweet, kind of spicy, very garlicky. Tons of flavor. It's good on almost anything.
This is the best glass of bourbon after a long day of shucking oysters.
And this is what we call our grill butter. It's basically garlic butter, lots of herbs. This is the last one.
So what do we do now?
They go in the oven.
Oh, okay.
Then we eat them.
After 5 minutes at 425, the butters are bubbling, the breadcrumbs are toasty, and I'm ready to dive into this succulent shellfish feast. Rockefeller's first.
So creamy. A little bit of the anise flavor in the Rockefeller and that crunch on the outside.
Grill next.
Herbs and butter.
Totally different.
Whoa, love that garlic. Exactly what we want, right? And then last is bourbon?
Bourbon.
Sweet, buttery. These three rock and roll with tons of flavor in a little pocket. Santa Barbara's best known for its scenic coastline and abundance of fresh seafood. And for the best of both, locals come here. The Santa Barbara Shellfish Company.
Established in 1980 as a buying station for fishermen, the Santa Barbara Shellfish Company has blossomed into a beloved full-service restaurant. This place is churning out some of the best shellfish in Santa Barbara. From uni-top scallops with plum sauce to hearty shellfish chipino served in a bread bowl. But the baddest bite on the menu is more than just a crabby crustacean. It's a Santa Barbara secret they call box crab.
I feel like this came out of Jurassic Park. What should one expect from eating a box crab?
So from my experience, the shell's a little softer. It's more of like a crack it and peel it.
So it's a deep water crab, but it's not as hard?
Exactly.
You're like my mentor when it comes to this, because I've never dealt with a box crab before.
You want to get in here a little bit?
I'd love to let you guys crack them open and then feed me. Look at this guy.
It's a little prehistoric.
I'm won over by all this meat. That's out of one claw. Look at all this meat.
The meat's definitely sweeter, and there's more flavor.
You can't beat the meatiness of these legs. You don't need any butter or lemon. You can just eat it by itself.
Point.
All the flavor's in there.
Yeah.
The chef behind the shellfish is owner Adam White.
Adam, how you doing, man?
Hey, how's it going, man? Nice to see you. Today, we're going to try the local box crab. One of our local fishermen brought it to us about 10 years ago, and
And no one was using it.
Nobody was using it.
Anyone that's traveling the country, coming from any side of the world that likes crabs should probably try this.
Yeah.
They're not very common. They're deep in the ocean, 8 to 2,500 feet from Alaska to San Diego.
Yeah.
And they're just gaining popularity now.
Not many people are fishing these.
I'm gonna be fishing these.
Yeah.
So box crabs get their name because they hide their legs and their claws underneath them.
That's right.
To hide from predators.
Yes, every single leg fits together perfectly, just like a perfect box. We just need them to go right into the boiling water and
that's it.
That's it.
How long do they cook for?
4 minutes at first, then we'll pull it out, take the carapace off, clean out the insides, and put it back in.
All right, so we're just gonna put them in?
Yep, throw them in there.
All right, let's put them right in.
And you can see how the color changes pretty immediately.
Adam serves every box crab with coleslaw and onion rings. So while the crab cooks, we take a mix of green and purple cabbage with carrots, then add apple cider vinegar, lemon juice, and honey.
So why honey?
Honey just gives it that little kick of sweetness. You know, bad coleslaw can be pretty bad.
Yes, so we add a little bit of honey to it. Yeah. A little bit of acid, it's gonna kind of liven up the actual
Absolutely.
Coleslaw.
After that comes the mayo.
Throw in some mayo, pineapple, and raisins.
I love it. I've never had pineapple or raisins in my coleslaw.
Throw some parsley in there, and it gives it a nice green, and I think you'll like it.
Then we mix it all together. When the coleslaw is ready, we drop a couple onions in the fryer and plate the massive box crab with an onion ring garnish.
That's it. That's the garnish.
Look at this thing. This is for one.
This sea monster's ready to eat.
How do we actually attack this thing? I mean, I know how to eat crabs, but show me the way, brother.
We'll just take the top piece off.
Just get rid of it.
And then what I like to do is just start with, you know, one of the legs. There's oftentimes a really good little morsel right there, but it doesn't get any fresher.
Wow.
Good?
It's so sweet.
Yeah.
And with one crank, we have all this meat from one of the legs. Oh, this is not gonna be pretty, but yeah. It's a little bit briny, but really, really, really sweet.
Yeah.
So it's naturally sweeter than any crab that I've ever had. I mean, there's so much meat in here.
Yeah, there really is a lot.
It's a crab lover's dream.
I'm at Crabby Joe's in Daytona Beach to take down the Surf and Turf Challenge, a sandwich encompassing everything from both land and sea. In this Surf and Turf War, food is going down. Built onto the Sun Glow fishing pier right over the Atlantic Ocean, Crabby Joe's serves up unbeatably fresh seafood with unbelievable views. But I'm here for the Surf and Turf Challenge. A 4-pound surf and turf burger made with 6 fried Mahi-Mahi fillets, totaling 14 ounces.
Are you ready to take on this challenge?
I'm ready! Let's do this! It's a really delicious burger. There's just so much of it.
This burger is way too massive to tackle altogether. So my plan is to deconstruct it into 4 manageable parts.
He's doing great. He's got a great pace going. He's hitting the land like a lion and the sea like a shark.
No more burger, no more fish, no more scavenger.
Crush the surf and the turf in under 20 minutes, leaving the veggies and the dreaded red.
Eat your salad! Eat your salad!
Using the veggies to break up the flavor, I managed to polish off the Texas toast, leaving the bun. The tide is rising.
One last fight! One last fight!
But I ride the wave to victory.
Total win for Casey.
Yeah.
Casey, congratulations. Yeah.